Hi everyone, in this video we'll discuss about robot configuration. So there are four robot configuration based on movements of joints and link arrangement. In that, first one is Cartesian coordinate configuration. So here I have drawn the sketch of Gantry robot, or also called as rectangular robot. It is a simple configuration among all with three prismatic joint. The robot functions in rectangular workspace by means of these three joint movements. These joints allow only in linear motions along three principal axes, that is X, Y, and Z. So it is also called as XYZ robot. Major application of this configuration include carrying high payloads, pick and place, material handling, used in a sealing, handling for plastic molding, 3D printing in CNC machine, used in plotter work. Now you see the advantages. This robot is high accurate and high speed. The cost is less. Simple operating procedure. Only the disadvantage is it requires large volume of space to operate. The next is cylindrical configuration. As you can see in this figure, it consists of two prismatic joints perpendicular to each other and one revolute joint mounted on rotary axis. Difference with Cartesian configuration is one prismatic joint is replaced by revolute joint. Vertical column carries arm assembly that move up and down. It also rotate about column. The cylindrical configuration is used in material handling, small assembly tasks, machine loading and unloading. Next is spherical configuration. It also called as a polar configuration. It has one prismatic joint and two revolute joint. First rotary movement occurs about a vertical base axis, while second rotary movement is of pure point about horizontal axis. Prismatic joint moves wrist rapidly in and out. This configuration allows robot to operate in spherical work volume. It provides larger work envelope than Cartesian or cylindrical configuration. Next is articulated configuration. It consists of three revolute joint and one prismatic joint. When arm rotates about all three major axes, result configuration is articulated configuration. It is also called as joint arm configuration. The arm of this configuration look like a human arm. It has two rotary joints, shoulder and elbow, about their respective horizontal axis. The third rotary joint is about vertical base axis. It is used in manufacturing of steel bridges, cutting steel, flat glass handling, heavy duty robot, automation in foundry industries, heat resistance robot, metal casting, spot welding. Now you see the advantages. This robot has high speed. It has large working envelope, great unique control over welding and painting applications. Here the only disadvantage is it requires dedicated robot controller like PLC. Next is SCARA configuration. It is a special version of a jointed arm robot whose shoulder and elbow joints rotate about vertical axis instead of horizontal. Its work envelope is cylindrical and much larger than all other configuration. The SCARA acronym stands for Selective Compliance Assembly Robot Arm or Selective Compliance Articulated Robot Arm. The robot was developed under the guidance of Hiroshi Makino, a professor at University of Yamanashi. The arms of SCARA are flexible in XY axis and rigid in Z axis. As you can see in figure, it is a representation of XYZ axis of SCARA robot. In the XY direction, the arm of SCARA robot will be compliant and strong in Z direction. This robot is used for various types of assembly operations. That is, here a round pin can be inserted in a round hole without blending. This robot are faster and cleaner than comparable robot systems. Now you see the applications of SCARA robot. SCARA robot are used for assembly, packaging, machine loading. Now we see the advantages of SCARA configuration. It has high speed capabilities, perform great in short stroke, it contain donut shape work envelope. Here the disadvantage is the robot requires dedicated robot controller like PLC.